Hello and welcome back here in Hamburg. We want to kick off the second part of the afternoon. We are now heading for the Extreme Photo Talks. And Olympus has done something. They have sent photographers all across the world with the new camera in their hands to shoot projects and then to come here to the show to talk about them and tell us what they think. Because at the end of the day, cameras are built for photographers and we should talk to photographers to know what the camera is good for. Let me start to introduce the three of them, Andreas, Daniel and Hannes. I will give deeper introductions to each of you later, but let's start with you. Andreas, you are a photographer, obviously. You were Photographer of the Year, elected by the German Society of Nature Photography. And what else do you do in life?
I do a lot, but as a photographer, I prefer to do landscape and wildlife photography, supporting conservation projects, supporting to create more awareness for the people about the nature around us and to protect that. So that's the reason why I'm doing photography.
That's a link very often found when you talk to nature photographers. Hardly ever they are only in for photography, they always are in for nature and they try to achieve something for nature by documenting what they see. Now, you went to an island.
Yes.
Madeira.
Yes.
Why Madeira and what did you do there?
Because Madeira is a nice spot and I was very interested in doing landscape shots there, especially the forests there with the laurel trees, because they are really unique in this island. And
let's look at the first picture so everybody knows what we're talking about. These are some of the oldest laurel trees in the world, I think.
I think so, yes. And this was really interesting to me because each of these trees has its own character, and I was there several times to shoot under different light conditions, under different weather conditions, and for me it was very important to be able to bring all the details. As you can see here, for example, the moss and the fern on the trunk and all the structures, to bring that details into the photograph at least. So that's the reason why I was really excited about the new camera, and that was also my intention to test it, the handheld high resolution mode, because this gives the possibility to bring all the details on the image at least. Yeah.
Precisely this image, tell me a little bit about how you took it. I know that Madeira is way down towards the south, so were shooting a sunset, and this was only a few weeks ago, right?
It was in December, yeah.
December, so probably a very short time to do the...
Yeah, as more south as you go to the equator, as faster you need to be to work with the light, because the light is just switched on and off and on the sunset. So time is critical, so and for that it's important to find the right angle to create a composition. And for this image I had in my mind to create this circle around the sunset and the clouds. And I needed the freedom to move around and to go up and down and to see where is the best position. And then shooting out of the hand a 50 megapixel photo is, I think every photographer knows that this is really a challenge. And I was excited and struck by the result, because I didn't believe it myself before that it's possible to do it out of hand without a tripod.
Okay. Another laurel tree image here, and this looks really foggy, or what is it?
Yeah, it was. This day was in the middle of clouds. It was raining, extremely wet, everything muddy, and I went around and tried to find some places to take good images, and for me it was really good to have this very good stabilization of the camera. I didn't use a tripod, because even it would sink into the mud. And it got totally wet, you know, it was raining. And the only thing I needed to care is keeping the lens clean, but nothing else. Because it's a tool, you know, for us, it's important that the camera is nothing where I need to care about. I want to care about the image. And yeah, I was just able to use it. And
we all know these pictures of nature photographers all wrapped up in plastic with plastic hoods on their cameras. Mommy. Not needed anymore.
No.
All right.
Yeah, for me, but not for the camera.
Okay, the third picture of laurel trees here, and I think one can see the information in this image of all the detail that's in there.
And if you look on the EXIF data, it's a 1/15th of a second. It was close to sunset. And the details needs a pretty sharp image, at least. And the handheld high-res mode is really working down to these long exposure times, which was surprising to me as well.
Okay. At one point, you must have gotten sick by the rain under the clouds. Yeah. You just went above them, right?
Yeah, it was all above the clouds. But it's because all that stuff is on the top of the island. But here, this was by accident. When I was on the way back to the hotel after a good shooting day, and it was almost, not really dark, but it was really, the sun was really set. And I've seen this situation, and I thought, that looks like a pillow, and I wanted to take a photo, but there was a fence in front of it, and I was climbing on the fence, and I was using the camera like this, and I shot out of the hand with a 2 seconds of exposure time, and got that result, and you can see it there, that it's pretty sharp. And
I mentioned this before, that 7.5 EV stops could mean up to 4 seconds out of hand. This is 2 seconds?
2 seconds, yeah.
So it works.
It works. It really works.
Yeah. Not only on paper.
Right?
Cool. Just to prove that Madeira has sun also, an image to give you an idea of what this island looks like. And another image that you wanted to talk about.
Yeah, because, Madeira is an island for hiking. People love to go there for hiking, and it's a very green and a very covered island with a lot of structure, with a lot of plants. And if you go hiking, it's important to have not much weight with you, even for people like me that are a bit more old, And this was in a very tight valley, about 10, 12 kilometers to walk there. And it was the first time that I did not take a tripod with me, really, for 15 years now, the first time that I did not take it with me. And I got there, and you can take images like this as high-resolution images to bring out all the leaves and all the details and have such results, which was really amazing to me. And I didn't miss the tripod.
Mr. Kataoka said this before, they just look at the equipment that photographers are using and they think, which ones can we eliminate by putting it in the camera.
And it works.
All right. So those are the images that you brought back. And we're talking specifically...
And with ISO 1600. Forgot to say, ISO 1600, pretty good image quality and, very convincing to me as someone who is really using these pictures for large-scale printing, for example.
Yeah, in the exhibition, one can take a closer look at these images and see all that information in there. Daniel, I would like to introduce you as well, even the two of you, Hannes, as well, because you both did a photo tour together. You're both part of the German Romers collective, photo collective. Before we go into detail about you, Hannes, what are the German Romers, which is a stupid question to ask because there's hundreds of thousands of people following you on Instagram, but for those who don't know yet, let me know what the German Romers are.
Yeah, so the German Romers is a collective of 14 German-based photographers, and we are trying to show the beauty of Germany with our social media on Instagram and our huge reach. We have the biggest outdoor community in Germany, in Europe, actually, and we are hosting community events like Insta walks or meetups or even workshops.
Okay. Yeah. And Instagram has been key for you, Daniel, to get into photography in a certain way. Huh? Can you tell that story?
Instagram. Well, I was living in New Zealand for a year and I wanted to share the beauty of this country with my family and friends. So I started getting into photography, and with that I started Instagram, and it kind of blew up, and I met Hannes, I met the other German Romers, and it all ended with over 600,000 followers. I don't know why.
So that is not so long ago that you got started in in photography, but that doesn't mean, oh sorry, I went back, that doesn't mean that you can't take great pictures such as this one.
Thank you. It's like we went with the new camera to Japan to capture the landscape and the urban environment, and this is one of these shrines that are standing somewhere in the landscape. And I placed Hannes there right on the edge to just show how big.
So Hannes is not only a photographer, he's also a model, a landscape model.
Need to teach him what to do, otherwise he's good. So this image is also a handheld high-res shot, and I had this awkward position because I was holding the camera above my head, trying to frame it with the tilt display, and I shot it at 1/60 of a second, which is just the border on high-res shot, handheld high-res shot, and it got super sharp. And the reason I shot it so weird was there were trees all around me, and I wanted to frame it without any trees to get this clean look.
All right. You're the second one to mention that the image stabilizer allows you to work like this, so I think the new thing to recognize Olympus photographers is like, this is the way they shoot, huh?
Maybe, yeah. Just opens up so much more angles.
Let me get into the next image, which is a bamboo?
Yeah, it's a bamboo forest in Japan.
In Japan, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And everyone who knows this place knows that it's quite touristy. And we got there in the morning, and of course there were so many people, so I couldn't shot it just straight with the walking path. So I decided to shoot it upwards to get these crazy bamboo just going into the middle of the image. And I shot it also high-res, and it's hanging on the wall back there, so you can just look at it and see all the details. There's every single leaf you can just see.
Okay, and then onto an encounter.
Yeah, it was a pretty crazy town because deers are just running around freely and they are so used to human so they come really close to you. So I was able to shoot that with 25 millimeter 1.2 and I used aperture 1.2 to create this soft bokeh, and the AF just worked fine. So I nailed it right on the eye and it's really sharp.
Okay. The next animals that you took pictures of, both of you took pictures of, Hannes, which is the moment I would like to introduce you a little bit more. How did you get into this?
Into
photography? And
yes, so I started 5 years ago or 6 years ago by downloading Instagram, and then I got my first camera and uploaded photos on Instagram, got lots of followers, and then started freelancing at some point.
Okay, the two of you obviously went together to Japan. This is still an image that you took, Daniel. Yeah. And the next one is you, Hannes. Tell me a little about this photo situation. How does it come about to take the pictures of these monkeys?
Yeah, so besides the amazing landscapes and urban cityscapes you can shoot in Japan, Japan also offers stunning wildlife. So our main goal on the trip was to capture the Japanese macaques, and they are usually living in the Japanese Alps, but during winter they are coming down into the valleys and bathing in those geothermal hot springs to stay warm during the winter. And so we visited them and tried to capture them, and
Okay. What's the challenge here? Let's take a look at the EXIF data, 1/800 of a second at ISO 400, 2.8. Are they moving? Is this difficult to take such a picture?
Yeah, it was actually quite challenging to get sharp images of the monkeys because they are running around all the time. But I got quite a lot with the super fast autofocus of the new camera. And also the previous shot, I actually shot with the new high-res handheld mode, which is incredible because you're even able to shoot wildlife with amazing image quality handheld without using a tripod or anything.
Okay. And another one, and this is the only reason to talk about Fuji today, because it's Mount Fuji that you see in the background here. How do you take this picture?
Yeah, so we were trying to get a nice and clear view onto Mount Fuji, and we visited some spots around the mountain, and there were like low-hanging clouds for like 3 days, and then at one sunrise it was just incredible light and super clear sky. So we were able to see Mount Fuji and have like a reflection of the mountain. And in that case, I was really flexible because I didn't use any tripod and I was able to get a handheld high-res shot to get all the details of like the foreground with the boats or even Mount Fuji in the back.
Okay. Everybody keeps mentioning handheld high-res shot all the time, so it's definitely something you used a lot.
Absolutely. Yeah,
absolutely. Okay. This is a temple in the middle of the lake?
Yeah, so this is actually shot with the new feature of the camera. It's called the Live ND. I usually forget my ND filters when I travel around or I lose them, so it's nice to have like a built-in Live ND function. So I took this without a physical ND filter on top of the lens and used the inbuilt ND filter to get like a long exposure of this shrine to get like the movement of the water and the clouds to appear like milky and smooth.
All right. Since the overall topic of this talk is image quality, can I get your final verdict on what you've seen? Is this really a step forward? Is this what you're going to use going forward?
Yeah, from my side for sure. Quality increased, noise is reduced, the range is increased, and this additional with this high-res mode is a stunning possibility, which I was really not believing before. But I did it, and I took photos, and I'm convinced.
Okay. Daniel, what was your experience with the camera? Yeah. What did you like? Was it a good tool to work with?
Absolutely. It was easy to work with, amazing image quality, and like Andrea said, the high-res shot is really a great feature because you can get easily 50 megapixel files, and with a tripod you can 80 megapixels, and it just allows you to keep your option open to have really large format prints like you see on the walls printed on 2.5 meters, and you can see all the details, and it's just an option that I like to keep for myself open.
Hannes, they gave the camera to you for the project. I think they took it away from you afterwards. Do you want it?
Yeah, absolutely.
But I keep it. Now, is this going to be something that you want to work with?
Yes, and I love the high-res shot, especially because you're able to get like a high-resolution image without tripod, so you can focus on your composition and you're really flexible, and I just love that.
Okay. The best proof for the high-res shot that was mentioned so many times here is the exhibition that we have over here, where you can see large, large prints. For the people out there in the stream, we have done a virtual tour of the gallery here in Hamburg. So you also can go through this, see that you can get these sizes of images out of the data that the EM1X captures. And so quality has to be seen. I can only invite you to do so and have a look at that. Also, once again, the invitation to speak to the guys, they're here. After this show, they're probably going to be everywhere in the world again and not so easy to grab. So do talk to them. Do also ask your questions to them in the social media channels, which especially Instagram, Olympus Europe and Olympus Suomi for Finland. And we'll answer those questions later. So thank you guys for being here. We'll be back with another one of those talks in just a little moment. Until then, see you.